The city of Orlando is hoping to create more than 3,000 new jobs.
And it aims to do it by moving ahead with the new Dr. Phillips Performing Arts Center. It'll be right across from City Hall and bordered by Anderson and South Streets and Rosalind and Orange Avenues. While hopes for the project are high, West 2's Greg Fox reports money is still a big concern.
We're at the intersection in downtown Orlando of South and Magnolia, and when you walk over here and see this blue fencing, this is where Orlando Fire Station 1 used to be. This is where you'll see the front of the new Performing Arts Center.
Orlando has tried for more than two decades to build a successor to the Bob Carr Performing Arts Center.
And the idea of the plaza is community involvement.
Now it could be mere months from groundbreaking to turn this model into an entertainment showplace, including the first two of three planned theaters. Rob Baker is with the construction management team.
Performing arts centers take 20 to 25 years from the original concept to when the doors are opened. And this is big.
Right now, the team is reviewing 363 bids from companies on 84 bid packages, covering all kinds of jobs, from electrical to masonry to painting work. Those bids will be turned into recommendations for City Council to approve in January. The big concern? That the bids come in at a price exceeding the $250 million that the Arts Center has to build Stage 1.
We know that there may be a gap on that. We're hopeful, because our design team was very efficient, to divide the building as close as possible to the current funds that we have.
Already, more than $7 million has been spent designing the center, with 31% of that work going to women and minority-owned businesses.
Then when we construct this job, they'll feel a part of it and become patrons as well.
Supporters of the Arts Center say it could be a really big draw for tourists. In fact, cultural tourism in Florida last year drew about 7 million people from out of state, spending $4.5 billion. In Orlando, Greg Fox, Washington News.